Hey everyone, back with another update on my hydroplane build, and still working on the transom. What you see here, well, besides these cats, who are great helpers.
Hey buddy.
Weirdo. And wonky. You have the transom frame that I had made the other day. My last video kind of outlines that process. I did all the joinery with the router, as well as the Japanese rasp, which I used to clean everything up in a chisel. Pretty standard joinery. It's not as tight as I would like it to be. You see there's some pretty big gaps here. Not super happy with that. It actually looks better on the side that's against the transom. It's another screw up on my part. But part of the reason for these large gaps is because I didn't account for any of the twist that occurs in the board. So things lined up on paper, and when I would flop them over a little bit, and the boards don't have a whole lot of twist to them, but still enough just to kind of throw things off a little bit. And when I did the glue up, it was just off by a fraction. And I checked everything out. It's 16th of an inch or a little bit more, you see. So I'm going to have to fill that in and hopefully cover it up a little bit. There's also a couple of spots you can see here that there was some tear out that occurred. And I'm going to have to fill that in too. Well, don't have to. It's going to be strong. It'll do its job regardless. And the next step that I did was go ahead and put the transom frame onto the mahogany transom piece and traced it. Went ahead and measured out where all the screws should go. So you can see I got a whole lot of screws, and went ahead and then drilled the screws, countersunk the holes. Something you should probably get if you don't have it and you're doing some countersinking. This is a great countersink bit. Real fast, accurate. It just leaves great countersinks. Is this type of bit that has a guide piece on it. So this is for an eighth inch screw. And, countersunk everything. Took a little bit more time to measure things out, so the screw positionings that are exposed look good versus some of the screws that I did on the frames that you see over here. They're a little bit more random. I did countersink some of them and put a little bit more thought into placement on some of the screws that are in the frame pieces, but I don't know. I was just kind of excited to get it done. So I went ahead, traced everything, drilled, countersunk, then glued up the transom framing, put the mahogany transom piece onto the transom frame, aligned everything. I actually cut this little piece here as kind of an alignment marker. Oh yeah, I also trimmed this down so that the transom piece was a little bit bigger, and I made sure to just trace the transom frame, and then I just did a rough cut with a jigsaw on the transom mahogany. That way there was clearance for the clamps to actually, fit and clamp everything together. Because if I had kept it as just one big board, there's no way I would have been able to get enough clamps on it. And I still don't, I don't know if that's enough clamps. There's spots where I would expect to see a little bit of squeeze out, and I did clean it up a little bit with a wet paper towel, but I was hoping for a little bit more squeeze out, get a little bit more glue contact on everything. But you know what? I think it's going to be solid. And so basically I went ahead, clamped the transom frame onto the transom mahogany that I cut out, and then drilled the pilot holes into the frame, and then screwed it on. And it's going to sit overnight. And then tomorrow I'm going to go ahead and just trim everything down to size. And then my transom will be complete. I'm going to take the transom and three frame pieces over there. I'm going to set them up and start building something that looks like a boat. So that's all I got for now. Bye.